in Napoli, where love is king. When boy meets girl, guess what they say.
Last day with our tour group, we're going to be exploring Venice. First we get to have some breakfast, of course, as per routine.
All the fruit. So we get the view of the nice little courtyard. It really feels like we're just living in Italy. And you can see the neat little roofs over there. So cool.
Andiamo! Tour of Venice, let's go!
What an amazing view of the water right through Venice. Such a concept. It's a bit cooler here, but the sun's coming out.
So we're heading to the church and museum in St. Mark's Square. Crossed over the bridge over there.
Now we came here. Our hotel's like right there. All right, now as per routine, instead of hopping on our bus, we hop on a boat.
It was built to celebrate the end of a plague which killed thousands and thousands of people. On your left side, in Venice we have 120 churches.
I don't like the feeling of a dock. Feels like we drank too much wine.
Alright, so we're heading in front of the group again. We have to cross four bridges, which is such a concept to me because I come from the dry land, but the streets are water. That's why there's so many bridges. There's so many people dressed up for the carnival in great grand costume.
My lover, 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 I'm in paradise whenever I'm with you. My mind, well, it's a paradise whenever I'm with you. Ride on. I will ride on down the road, I will find you, I will hold you, I'll be there. It's long, well, it's a mighty long road, but I'll find you, I will hold you, and I'll be there.
I know you heard it from those other boys, but this time it's real, it's something that I feel it. I know you heard it from those other boys, but this time it's real, it's something that I feel it.
There you go. There's a sauce for you. A little bit bigger than the one we had.
Yeah. Looks cold and a little bit dingy.
Walking through the prison.
So we're leaving the Doge's palace now, and we're heading to the church. It was so beautiful in there, a lot of gold.
Glass composition basically is really poor. So soda, potash, and silica sand, that's it. Now you see the glass still incandescent. But remember, glass born clear, no colors. So to get a colors, we use different minerals of fiber. I made us no machine computers, three tools, only pipe, a pincer, and scissors, and that's it. The cylinder of clear glass inside in the molder, you have something like a crisscross design. Okay. And now with a special kind of pincer, maybe it starts to give a shape. So no school, no university. But years, years, and years of apprenticeship. And now we start to blow. Inside the pipe have a small hole. You can see the hair is going through.
Yeah.
Master can make everything. Yeah? So drinking glasses, vase, then chandelier, sculpture, large, up to human size, or bigger than me. My band, and then turn it this upside down, sticking the pipe on the bottom without using the view, just a glass. again inside with the cardboard glass on top. You spread it on the neck. And now, look at that, it's going to stretch the handle one go. So before the glass become unmanageable, it's very difficult. Look at it. Oh. Mamma mia. Each piece is one, okay? And you find when you find a small bubbles, so it's not means not good. This is another technique of work. It's the one we call a sculpture. So in this case, it doesn't need the pipe anymore. Wow. Of course, this one is just a short demo, eh? Normally, it's working with a tool of three helpers, we call piazza in Italiano, means a square. See, start from the head, mane, legs, and give a shape to the body. And then finish with a tail. This is a Ferrari horse. Same thing, eh? When the piece is done, then we'll put it inside. Huge piece, 48 hours, sometimes even more inside. So. Yes.
Wow.
Easy, eh?
Yeah. Wow, very good.
We just got to go to the glass blowing factory. We saw a demonstration. That was really cool. Very pricey, but very interesting nonetheless. It's really an art form.
Wow, that's quite the calzone.
Oh man, beautiful. Lots going on with the carnival. Walking around during carnival here. This wasn't planned, it just happened to be carnival when we arrived here. Now we're going to get to do our gondola ride. We had a very quick lunch. They were a little bit slow.
It was very quick.
Yeah, it was a nice place, but a little bit slow. Feel underdressed. So now we're on the gondola.
When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Scusa mi, but you see back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Music in a tight little canal. Our gondola ride, and it was so much fun.
That was neat. That was really neat.
We went in the narrow canal.
Catherine had the best seat in the gondola.
I was sitting like in the front so I could see all these bridges as we smoothly rode past.
And the serenade was really neat too.
Yeah,
we were
really
serenaded by the gondolier.
It was just so peaceful and it feels like
it
a dream.
Really neat.
Yeah. It was really neat. Can't believe we actually did that. So we just took the bus, but here in Venice, it's
a water bus.
Yeah, it's a water bus, so it's a bit different than back home. Probably stays more on time than the bus back home, but it was a fun experience because you're really just driving with the locals and we got to see all the buildings on water as we walked through or drove through. What did you think, Nin?
It was a very interesting ride. I especially liked that it was just the people who live here who were using it. And we saw everything because we went so far on the route.
And as my aunt was saying, we've now taken every kind of boat there is in Venice. We've had the taxi, we've had the
gondola,
the shuttle,
the bus.
So we've got all the experience. I don't know if I'd be able to do it every day though, because I do get a little queasy. Go, our daily gelato is a must. I was feeling a little underdressed, so when in Rome, well, even though we're not in Rome,
nice.
Putting in for the carnival. Right, we're being classy, we're sitting down at our high tea chairs for coffee. I know, back home you don't eat the bread when it's green.
No, that's true.
This is being a pastor!
We believe you!
If you think I was nice, it is very simple. It's because you deserve.
Here's some chicken, il pollo. So we just had our farewell supper.
Yes, which was very good.
Said goodbye to our tour director, gave him a hug. Nicest guy. He loved my attempts at Italian and just was so accommodating.
Yeah, he was very nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For supper, we had too much food. This dress feels too tight, like I had to untie it.
You're getting fat.
You're
getting so fat, Catherine.
It's the pasta. It's the pizza. On my birthday, I'm going to Montana's and I'm having pork and French fries. Need some meat. Anyways, it's been amazing and it was great to just have a final night with everyone and bid them farewell. So we're on the choo-choo train heading to Verona. So we're walking in downtown Verona. It's kind of a zoo. But we did get to go see Juliet's house, which I really thought was cool.